Multiply and divide rational expressions by Allison Hammack. Number one, let's multiply x minus 1 over 4x times x plus 3 over x minus 1. So the first thing we want to do is we're going to multiply the numerator, multiply the denominator, and then lastly, and simplify the results. So let's go ahead and do this. So we multiply the numerators. So we have x minus 1 times the quantity x plus 3 all over 4x times the quantity x minus 1. Now, lastly, we're going to simplify the results. We want to remove both of these because they can both go to 1, goes to 1, goes to 1. And now we're left with x plus 3 all over 4x as our simplified answer. Okay, example number 2. You'll see we have a little different scenario here. We have x squared minus 4 over x plus 3 times x plus 3 over x plus 2. This portion here, we're going to need to factor. So we need to factor this, factor using the difference of perfect squares. So this portion here, we will get x squared minus 4. We can factor this as an x plus 2 times the quantity x minus 2. So now let's go ahead and put this back into our problem. So we have x plus 2 times the quantity x minus 2 in the numerator, x plus 3 in the denominator. We're going to go ahead and multiply the numerators times the denominator. So we also have an x plus 3 in the numerator here. And then we also have an x plus 2 in the denominator down here. So now lastly, we're going to simplify. And what we can do is remove the things that are the same in the top and the bottom because they both go to 1. And we have our final answer now here is x minus 2. That's our complete answer for this problem. So let's look at another problem here, number 3. All right, number 3, we have a trinomial in the numerator over a trinomial in the denominator times a binomial in the numerator, binomial in the denominator. So the first thing we're going to need to do is we're going to have to factor the expressions. So looking at the numerator here, let's work with this piece first. 2x squared minus x minus 3, we need to factor this. This is going to factor into 2x times x, and we will get minus 3 plus 1. And this, if you multiply this all out, this will get us the inner product of a negative 1. So next, we're going to have to then factor this. We have to factor the denominator, 3x squared minus 8x minus 3. Let's go ahead and factor this expression, this trinomial. So this is going to factor into 3x plus 1 times x minus 3. So let's go ahead and put this all back together now. Back up here at the top, we're going to have our factors here. 2x minus 3 times x plus 1 over this one here was down here. 3x plus 1 times the quantity x minus 3. And let's go ahead and multiply it out now times this other expression over here. 3x plus 1 and 2x minus 3 quantity. Now notice that this did not factor and this denominator did not factor either. So lastly, when we get to this step here, our next what we want to do is simplify this to our lowest terms. So we're going to look for things that are the same in the numerator and the denominator and cancel them out and make them go to 1. Here we also have something the same, similar to this. These two cannot be removed, so they are our final answer is x plus 1 over x minus 3. Okay, so now we're going to divide rational expressions. Our first example here, number 4, is 5 over 2x divided by 10 over x minus 4. So what we're going to do is we're going to multiply the first expression by the reciprocal of the second. So we keep our first expression, and we change the sign of multiplication, and then we're going to multiply by the reciprocal of this. So this becomes x minus 4 over 10. And now we're going to simplify this. Simplify. So we want to look here on the diagonal. 10, we can cross 10 out and write it as its factors, 5 times 2. So now when we look up here, we have a 5 here as well. So we can cross out the 5, so this will go to 1. Looking here on this diagonal, we cannot remove this x because this x is attached with subtraction. So we cannot just cancel them. We are left with those. They are not factors. So we multiply across. We get x minus 4 over the quantity of 2x times 2. So let's write that as 4x. And this is our final answer. We cannot simplify this any further. We are done. Looking at number 5, let's divide these two expressions. So when we're going to go ahead and divide, remember, let's write it out in words here. We need to multiply the first expression by the reciprocal of the second. So let's go ahead and do that work here on this problem. So when I look at this problem, though, I see that I'm going to have to do some perfect square. This I have to factor. I'm going to need to factor this difference of perfect squares like we did on the other problem. So let's go ahead and first just rewrite it. Let's rewrite our problem without factoring it first. Now we can think of this as x minus 3 over 1. So we change this to multiplying it by its reciprocal. And now this is the problem we're dealing with. So now we want to factor this. So x squared minus 9 is going to factor into an x plus 3 times the quantity x minus 3. And our denominator here is just x squared plus 4. This does not factor. Let's make a little note here. Does not factor. Go ahead and multiply it. So we have a 1 up here on the top times 1 over x minus 3. Now we want to simplify. We can remove this and this. This does not factor, so we cannot do anything with it. Multiply this across. Now we have x plus 3 in the numerator and x squared plus 4 in the denominator. Okay, our last problem here, problem number 6. Let's first change our division to multiplication. So we keep the first expression. Then we're going to go ahead and multiply it by its reciprocal. So next, I'm going to have to do some factoring. So next, I want to factor. So I notice this is the difference of perfect squares. So let's go ahead and write that as a plus b times the quantity a minus b. And there's something I can factor out of these, so we'll just keep those terms. And then in our denominator, this also is the difference of perfect squares, difference of perfect squares, so we need to factor this. So this is going to factor into, what is the square root? That's 2a, and then the square root of 9b squared is going to be a 3b. So we're going to need this 2a and the 3b, so let's come over here and write it. We'll have 2a plus 3b times the quantity of 2a minus 3b, and then we still have this term here, b minus b. Now we're ready to go ahead and simplify. So you notice this quantity and this quantity will both go to 1. And we also have this and this will go to 1. So what are we left with here? We'll put the answer over here. We have a plus b in the numerator. And then in the denominator, we're left with a 2a minus 3b. And the problem is complete.